at least encourage you to put more and more money into the pot and chase the person who already had a made hand. That was tremendously inspiring to people whose gambling impulse wanted as much money in the pot as quickly as possible.
The Civil War also played a hand in changing hands. During the war, soldiers started betting to draw more cards that might help them win. Somehow it reminded the men of the stud horses that helped them pull their cannons out of the mud. Stud poker was born. The new games never stopped coming. Omaha 8, 7-card stud, high-low split. Today, Doyle Brunson and his fellow world-class players know them all. Call it self-defense.
They start new games because they try to keep the specialists out of the game. In other words, a guy's a real good holding player, he might be a bad 7-card stud player. You know, so you have to be a well-rounded player to be able to set in this company. You can't be some kind of a specialist and play.
Being a well-rounded player served Doyle well in the days when he was going around Texas with Amarillo Slim, Sailor Roberts, and Crandall Addington.
There were producers every place. You could find games any place.
And usually, the police, too. Gambling was illegal in Texas in the 50s.
We got arrested a lot, you know, but...